Chito, finger throw. Turn your hand for the choke. It's like punching. To escape, I take my chin, rotate it out and down. This often gets lost in the technique. The minute he pushes, I lower my chin and push his arm to break the hold. Moving back in itself breaks his posture. This is why we move back and release. The hand rises and breaks his balance again. And from here, releases the grab into a motegiaku. From here, we have a number of variations. The basic one is to continue in this direction. I can simply continue turning, bring my arm over, and pivot. Let's see this from the other side. Actually, we have here two locks happening simultaneously. We have the omotegiaku and pressure on the elbow with the body. Another way we work here is to leave the boshi on his neck, controlling him all the way down. As you can see, the choke has characteristics of a punch. So when he attacks with a punch, it's the same. Notice the evasion outside. Avoid, catch the arm, strike and lock. Hosoku, seizure. The attacker expects an attack up here. I attack down here, pushing and sinking him. This brings his head forward, leaving it open for a head strike. We can use the hand here as well. Or like this. Let's see this from the other side. This hand brings his face to wherever I need it. Against the tsuki, we work from this position using the same strikes as before. The principles are applied here against a knife attack. The evasion, attacking the balance, and the headbutt. Hoteki, abandon. You block like this, it's not effective. Do it like this. Sink and block using an uwashito. Sink, off balance. Switch hands, locking the attacker's arm, and step across, throwing him. The timing of the kuzushi and block must be very clear. From here, the hands switch and enter for the throw. There aren't many steps here. One, two, three. Secure the lock. The direction of the throw can be changed.
Ah!
I block and lock. Then step. One, two, throw and finish. This is a very dangerous throw. The same with the weapon. Controlling the arm. Block. Attack. Control the arm and take down with a lock. This idea can be applied with any weapon against any weapon. In this case, a modern day weapon such as a gun. Avoid and pin the weapon and hand while controlling the grabbing hand. Step in, apply an elbow lock with the body, taking him down. As in all techniques, the initial avoidance is crucial. Controlling the attacker's weapon allows us to use it to our advantage. Pivot to avoid, grabbing the top of the gun. Then use it to apply take-ori, followed by omotegi-yaku and a takedown. Going out the other way using muguri and gaining control of the gun from under it, or more of a daken approach. As you can see, the possibilities are infinite.